Hey everyone, welcome to Tiddy's Music Guidance. I'm Jack and welcome to episode 2. Today I'm going to be going through some music recommendations and we've got two exclusive videos for some really cool bands. So let's get on with the show. We're going to start with a really cool band that I heard this week. It's been out for a few years, but I've only just heard it this week and I thought this is absolutely brilliant and I needed to share it with you. So the first song I'm going to go through today is called Rocky Said and the band is called Dead Ghosts. Now, this is a really great, uplifting, summery song. It's really cool. Now, Dead Ghosts are a five-piece band from British Columbia and the music genre that they specialise in is garage band music. Lo-fi sound to them. Now the song starts off with a really great surfer-like guitar break and then the song just expands into a real jangly guitar rhythm which hooks you straight away, and when you start listening to the vocals then it really adds to the attitude of the song. When you listen to the song, it almost sort of starts reminding you of bands like The Coral, The Alalas, and also early Beach Fossils as well. Now, I really, really, really enjoy listening to it. I must have replayed this song over and over and over again. And it's just great because the weather's been really bad over here in London over the past week, and just hearing this song has really brightened up my day. It's turned a miserable day into a really sort of delightful, reminiscent of the summer tracks, even though we didn't have much of a summer, but it just reminds you of them hot summer days. It's just the catchy riff will really make you want to listen to the track again. So check them out, Dead Ghosts, Rocky Said. Now, this is an exclusive for you viewers today. We got a video exclusive with a really cool band. The band I'm going to be talking about today is Diga, and this song that I really want you guys to listen to is a song called Ghosts of the Deep. They pride themselves on being the disciples of 80s, 90s, alternative rock, shoegaze. And I'm really, really excited because they've actually created a intro and explaining what the song is actually about. So I'll take you over to them now. Here is Diga.
Hi, this is June from the band Diga and you're watching Tilly's Music Guidance. If you get a chance, check out our new EP available on most streaming platforms, Future World on Hold. It's a song telling the story of an astronaut's final moments in space before he drifts off into the unknown, probably never to be seen or heard from again. It's a spooky song and has a spooky guitar riff to go with it. When Sean first threw it at me, I knew right away where to go with this. It became very apparent and it allowed us to express ourselves in a way we usually don't. We usually go for a much more layered approach to music. But with this one, I think it was important to keep it minimal, to keep it a little bit more bare bones. Everything around Sean's vocal melody and his guitar riff is very sparse. We wanted to capture the feeling of someone in space, losing contact with everything he knows. And his final thoughts, his final emotions, knowing that he'd probably never see the earth, his family, his friends, or whatever, his life is gone. And he's going off into the great unknown. And I think we captured that.
Thank you. Wow, that was really awesome. So make sure that you follow all them links and check them out. Ghosts of the Deep is a really, really awesome track. It's cool, it's chilled, and it's actually, you know, it's laid back. It's a real mood healer and a song that you can just drift off into the oblivion. They've also just released their brand new EP, so it's an exclusive to speak to them, but just as they were just releasing that. So please make sure that you go check them out now. Now, my next track is called by a band called Goat, and the song is called Golden Dawn. Now, they're a Swedish band, and what their music can be described as is Afro-Psychedelica, Voodoo, Space, Neo-Psychedelica. That's as crazy as that sounds. That's basically how crazy the song is. I heard it this week and I thought to myself, wow, this is a mental track, but it's really enjoyable. It really has a great rhythm. It really kicks out into some really great music. So if you like your psychedelic sounds from the 70s with a modern twist, then this track is definitely one you want to hear. The instrumental is absolutely brilliant, and I'm going to give you a sample now. Just enjoy it. Crazy song from what looks like an absolutely really crazy band. So check them out now. We have another video exclusive today, this time from a project called Sixfourzerotwo. Now, they've just released a 8-year special video because they've been together for creating music for 8 years, and we've got an exclusive that I want to share with you. So check this out. So they're a post-punk, independent, not-for-profit project. And as I said, they released that video to celebrate 8 years of working on music. They're rooted in the post-punk ethos. So thank you for providing me with that track. Hope you enjoyed that. Now, I'm going to give you a Synthwave special here. Now, not many people know what Synthwave is, but Synthwave is an absolute joy to listen to. It's like the 1980s has suddenly come back. It's like they've time traveled in the DeLorean and come straight back to the modern day. Now, For those of you who don't know what Synthwave is, it's simple. It's just beautiful synthesizer keyboard sounds with a modern twist. It's like listening to a soundtrack of an 80s film that's brought back with a really cool nostalgic feel to the music. Now, it was made popular by many things, but two things that stand out the most is probably Hotline Miami and that cult film, which is one of my favourites, is Drive, because of the sounds that it was actually given. Now, Lazerhawk is a synthwave artist, and he's one of the well-known artists around the synthwave scene. He's released numerous albums, and the one album that really sticks out for me and what really got me into synthwave music was an album called Visitors. Now, it's imagine if Daft Punk met Kraftwerk in space. That's basically how you would probably sum up this album. You know, it's a great album. It's instrumental all the way through, and you know, every single track is a killer. It's brilliant. There's no filler songs on this album. Every single song has its own, you know, completely different dimension and sounds to the album. Lazerhawk manages to merge the 80s synthesizer sounds with added sort of electronic music and disco as well. Now, my favorite song on this is called Lazerhawk's Theme. It's the opening track on the album, and wow, it's just, even though it's quite a slow song, it has quite a powerful beat to it, and it's just really dark, it's really futuristic, and it really is a joy to listen to. So, Synthwave is brilliant. Lazerhawk, give it a chance. Give it a listen to and let me know what you think. You know, some really delightful moments in that album. And straight away, you start daydreaming about the 80s. Now, I was only born halfway through the 80s, but I know, you know, you think about all them films, all the computer games around the time, the music. You just start automatically thinking about stuff like that and going into an 80s daydream. So my next song that I recommend today is a Australian band called Pleasure Symbols, and the song is called Image Reflected. Now, what I like about this song is it brings the beauty of the 80s style of the post-punk movement, which is reminiscent to the early Cure and Susie and the Banshees. Now, the song uses some droning minimal synthwave sounds to create kind of like a sense of delirium. The opening song has a slow beat and chiming guitars that really start reminiscing moments of The Cure's Pornography album, and also when the vocalist starts singing, you automatically start thinking, wow, she's on par with Susie from Susie and the Banshees, because she's got that real sort of husky, dark, slow rhythm to her voice. It's dark, it's moody, but the jangling of that guitar is absolutely haunting all the way through. The song has reminiscent elements all the way through, and you can clearly tell that this song pays tribute to all of that gothic rock, new wave, cold wave scene. So really check the band out, they're really awesome, and yeah, I love this song. Now, my final song that I am going to recommend today is a Russian band. Okay, called Life on Venus, and the song is called What Lies Beneath. Now, Russian music is really starting to become quite popular around the alternative scene. You've got bands like Pink Shiny, Ultra Blast, and Nooms, as well as Life on Venus. When you listen to this song, it's just an absolute shoegaze gem, and it has a lot of 90s grunge alternative scene. You know, when I first listened to the track, I had to sort of like find out what part of the early 90s it was from. But it wasn't. It's a modern song which pays tribute to all the excellent bands of the time. It's just a really well-made, modern shoegaze song. When you listen to the uplifting guitar works that just churn and peel in the background, just makes this song just desirable to listen to. Now this is a great tune and has a very calm and steady feel to it. Check them out, this is really awesome. This is Life on Venus and What Lies Beneath. That's the end of the show today, folks. Thank you so much for listening. And a big special thank you to the awesome band Diga and the brilliant 6402. Thank you so much for providing me with them videos. They were absolutely brilliant. And I hope you all enjoyed that too. Make sure you tune in next week. There'll be some more exclusive interviews. There'll be some really awesome music that I'll be recommending. And I'm going to be doing a top 10 list. Who's it going to be? What's it going to be? Tune in next week. So please like my videos and please also subscribe. See you later.